Anvila has this amazing ability about her. You read about it. You hear about it. And I know a person. Anvila is one of these people that can do this stuff. And what she can do, I mean, her visuals are wide open. She can tune into a person. And you can see more of this sort of work on the Farsight Institute with Courtney Brown. He's got his people, professional remote viewers and scanners. Avila does something very, very much like that, but a little different. But they come at it a different way. They target things differently. But they're right in there. They're in the now, facing, talking to, or are they in the space like a spaceship or something? They're with an entity and seeing and observing what they're doing, you know, from a remote view perspective. But then that being might turn on them and look at them. What are you doing here? It's like it's all of a sudden, it's not remote viewing. It's being there. So it's a phenomenon. I understand it pretty well. But Avila can do it really well. So she can shift consciousness into these different planes, into these different realms, and tune into people's stuff.
Chakras. So if you blast a chakra somehow, you blast the body. And like it doesn't go anywhere. Like it's in the vessel, but like it's different parts. And it's like a little like a mess right there, like, you know, like part here of one like energetic body, and it like scrambled all around, and like I was putting them back together, and like they're like you know, conscious and fully alive, so like we'll see what happens.
Okay.
Good. Okay. I'm feeling differences in my whole body. Like corrections in my neck, like interesting.
How's your hip
doing? I have some spots to try and crack now after doing some of this.
Yeah. Okay, so.
Yeah, so now that, like, I think I've worked enough on chakras and energies and stuff, I think the next step I could go is through some past lives or any similar incidents where that impact causes, like, sort of, like, same, you know, reaction and everything.
Same trauma to the body and the other etheric bodies and astral bodies and stuff. Yeah.
So that'd be anything connected and like work on that. Another thing, in the email you mentioned those like four purplish beings with robes and stuff.
Yeah.
Have they done anything to you or like, you know, like anything that stands out?
Nothing. I haven't had anything that's really reminded me of that since it happened.
Yeah.
But I've thought back to it a lot. Like, what the fuck was that?
Yeah. You want to look into that?
Sure. Uh-huh. Like both, like the beings that move those robes, see if like, you know, there's any connections or the good guys helping you out or like they're actually messing with you, and also go to your past lives, see if there's like any similar impacts with like causing similar trauma and stuff.
Yeah, your choice.
All right.
Yeah. Okay. Start.
I was talking to these beings, and basically they're the good guys. It's like, the race is called like strummers. It's like strumming, but strummers, like something like it. They were wearing robes because their real looks are kind of like weird. It's like, the best I can explain is the mix between the orc and the deer. It's like weird. But they have like sort of orc face, and then it goes into like bigger head with like sort of kind of antlers and like, you know, like no fur, just like skin and stuff, but like they're kind of weird. And it's like a... they have this alien qigong where they're like working purely through energy, and they can like, they're really like the masters of energy, like making it flow purely. And this is like their thing, like this is like whenever they see beings, doesn't matter where they are, who they are, wherever the energy is blocked, it's like, oh, that's their thing, we're gonna help them. And they're like, you know, like doesn't matter who it is, like it's just their thing, they like helping people to feel their fully like energy fully. And so they come and help you, but at the time when they were like working on you, it's like you are right here, and there's this shielding or like a cloak like around you. It's like by those like reptilians and other beings that are messing with you. So it's like they have to pierce the shielding to help you out, and like, you know, it's like a lot of work, and they get attacked by other beings.
When she does it, she looks into a person's space. She can see the entities. There's so many different kinds of entities, but that'd be one kind of entity, another kind of entity, another kind of entities. There's groups of entities, there's clusters of entities. You can take this consciousness that used to be in a human body. But before they were in human bodies, they were spiritual beings floating around as a viewpoint here or there, doing things in the multiverse for millions of gazillions of years, being in bodies and doing this, these beings, they can't do what we can do or what we could do, but they have technology that's highly advanced, and they have a great grasp of psychology and how beings think and behave and how their minds work. And so they're working at, you can call them the reptilians or the mantis beings or the tortoise beings or anything, ET, they're multidimensional and extraterrestrial beings in and out of this universe. So they've taken us from a higher universe and it's like stuck us in the Matrix universe. And that's where we get this idea that this is a simulation and it's created by the mind. We're trapped within the mind and we think this is reality. So it gets that deep and strange. So one of the things that's happened to us here, now that they've got us in these bodies, they want to keep us from waking up. They want to keep us from thinking clearly or being conscious and aware. So the way they do it is with other entities, other beings that they've captured. And they electronically captured this being and this being and shoved them together. It's like capturing you and some other guy and shoving you together with electronics and all kinds of pressure and stuff. And they're... and leave you unconscious for a million years, and you come out the other side, and you and this other guy think you're one person. But then, not just one, but two. Let's not just slam two or three people, beings together, and get them all confused into being one, and have them live together. But then, let's just add on 100, and then 1,000, and then maybe 1,000,000. Can they do it? Yeah, they can. If they can, they will. And they can. And they did. So this game of spirit and consciousness blending together and coming apart and blending together and coming apart in good ways and bad ways. You know, there's the whole idea of I used to be more of a whole being and I feel like I've been splintered or fragmented. Yeah. Yeah. So there's aspects of you smeared all over the multiverse that would love to get back with you. And it's a good thing. So you can merge and get, it's called soul fragment retrieval, or soul splintering. And you bring it back and you can bring it back in and you feel more whole, more fulfilled. Okay? All righty then. Bye, you guys. Hey, I wanna meet you live in a do a little live scan. Our Bill and I will get into your stuff and see if we can get the fuck out of here, mom. Gone. Find out some weird shit you agreed to. Get the fuck cancel. Undo that. Find out where you came from, what the hell you were doing, who are you messing around with, who'd you piss off? That's usually how it works when we find a client. It's like, who'd they fucking piss off? Yeah. If you're getting shit right now in your life, and it's like, it just doesn't seem like the fucking neighbor's dog's doing it. There's a very good likelihood that you or some other aspect of you, some other place, has been pissing off some people. So who'd you fucking piss off? We can figure out that. We can look. I say figure out. That's me thinking about it. I feel like it just looks. She sees that kind of shit. A lot of fun. Okay? All right. That's it. Take care now.
So they got pushed away. So they're trying to help. They have to work around other shieldings and different things. So they're trying, but they're not actually succeeding. And like a few times, like, oh, fuck, we can't do anything. So they sort of gave up. But like, I just found those beings, and they were like, just curious and interested in helping you, but like, no real like relations by stars or any past lives or anything. They're just like someone who's willing to help. So they're okay, I guess.
That's pretty cool.
Okay, so I guess like right now I'll go jump into the past. I've seen like, if I can find anything similar by traumatic incidents and get rid of them. And you know, if you have any ideas, feel free to share.
Okay. Yeah, I think it's a good way. Look for the similar damage incidents earlier, similar, the most basic one of that specific kind of damage to the body and the chakras.
Yeah. Okay. And basically we're looking at two cases, like they have to do with the past lives, agreements, and other incidents. So it seems like in one of the past lives, you were like traveling from like another, like different dimensions and different realities, and you end up in a realm where, hey, it looks like a nice place, but every being like sees you as like too powerful, and they're like, hey, we're not gonna play with you, you're too good, you're gonna like, you're a cheater, you're gonna win anyway, so they're like, not interested. And you decide like, hey, it's gonna be fun, I'm just gonna minimize myself and make sure like, you know, like I can fit them and adjust. So basically, you have to take away your own abilities and powers and sort of be like everyone else, sort of adjusting to fit in the system. And by that, sort of like it's the energy goes through the stomach, like, you know, like this is like taking out your own energy and stuff and shrinking a little bit. Like, and there's that thing again where, you know, like you start going this, like that way. So, you know, like there's one incident. And the second incident, it seems like in one realm, beings like they don't have understanding and they don't even want to understand. They just see you as like too powerful godlike being, and they're like having that like awe where they're like admiring you, but they have fear and they're not willing to risk. So they're like, oh, we're gonna capture him, take away his abilities, and then he can hang out here. So it's just like you're like a giant being that they capture, and they're all end up like just trying to like take out your energy again from the stomach, and you don't want to hurt them. Like, you know, like you're a good being. You're like, okay, well, just like, I don't want to hurt you. Like, you one shoving with the hand, like 10,000 of them go away. So basically, you're not doing that. But then again, they start taking you apart, and that's another instance of this. So I was going through these senses of what's going on, and, mm-hmm. like, and then I'll be undoing all these.
Okay, good, yeah. Interesting. Okay, yeah, keep up the good work.
All right. Mm-hmm.